Good evening. Good evening, music lovers. It's Sunday, June 7th, another edition of Sunday Night Chat Night here at the home of DJ's headquarters. Greeting you all. As usual, I'm not alone. Yes, I'm your host, Regalo Senior, mostly known as Mpo, my real actual name. I'm sitting here as usual with my co-host, co-pilot, Mr. C, Kaifas.
Solo boy.
AKA, so
you solo man.
You couldn't even let me finish.
Good evening, everybody. And yeah, welcome to another great night of chat night here at Home of DJs.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's start this, man.
Yeah, man. Another interesting week that we went past.
For sure. That was awesome.
Yeah. Yeah, like the 2 days.
Yeah.
It feels like, yeah, 2 days ago. I know exactly. We always say this.
Exactly.
Every Sunday when we're chilling here, we always say it feels like it's 2 days ago when you were just sitting here and talking to you guys. And again, today seems like, yeah, it seems like just 2 days ago we were having a conversation and, you know, speaking with Stuma.
Yes.
Doesn't feel like long ago.
Yes. Yeah. Somehow, yeah, the frequencies are just so quick, man.
But when we're not having one, actually, it feels like it's taking longer.
Exactly.
You know, we can't wait for another one. We can't wait for Sunday.
Yeah.
Now Sunday comes and then it's like, wow, actually the week is just, it's quite short.
Absolutely. Doesn't feel like 7 days anymore.
Yeah, no, damn. It's crazy. How's everyone doing tonight? Yes, it's another Sunday night chat night. We're at the home of DJ's headquarters. Let's have another catch up. Let's talk about what's happening in the world, what's happening around you. Obviously, not only limiting it to musicians. A friend of mine actually told me, hey, you know what? You need to be open. You can't just make everything about DJs.
Yeah, no, for sure. No, I agree. Yeah,
but it wasn't though, you know. Yes, it's home of DJs, but the conversations I think were more open, you know.
I think they quite inclusive of you know, the great community out there.
Yeah.
Some of the DJs obviously are people that you know, people that you hang around with.
Yes.
So yeah, it's with other people, there's no DJs.
No, most definitely.
I mean, I think what makes the DJs it's basically apart from the music, it's also the audience, you know.
Yes.
I think so. Not to say what makes a great DJ, but what I'm saying is it's complete when it's, you know...
it's a whole package.
Yeah, it's given to the people. So
yeah,
they do have a comment on that.
Awesome.
Yeah. So yeah, just maybe lay out the night. What do you have on store for us tonight?
Tonight, as usual, we have another exclusive... it's exclusive to Home of DJs, but some of you may have probably heard it already on Friday, 2 days ago. So this was recorded last Friday. That's the mix playing in the background, some really soulful deep house. We called it the Return of the Soul Man. It was very specific, this one. Another friend of mine asked me, okay, where was the Soul Man all along? If you're listening, Hank, you and I are going to have problems. Alright, so just a shout out to everyone who's listening and if any of you guys are struggling to hear us or anything like that, please just put it in the comments so that we can try and address that issue if it's originating from here, obviously. So let us know and we'll, yeah, man, we'll try and sort it out and make sure that we can all have a clear conversation.
Yeah, so, yeah, welcome everybody. Let's try to get a feedback from you guys if the audio is quite clear and everything.
Yeah. Welcome again. I think I did welcome everybody, right?
Yes.
Okay. Diva says we must just increase the volume a bit.
Okay.
Are you referring to the music volume or us speaking, Diva? The reason I'm asking is because the music is actually, the volume is quite low intentionally while we're still speaking. But if you're referring to our voices, then I guess I'll have to try and sort that out. Oh, us. Okay. Now I'll try and put it up just a little bit.
Okay, yeah, let's sort that out quickly then.
I just increased the volume. Hopefully this changes something. You can hear us a little bit clearer now. So yeah, thanks for that kind of feedback, Devo. Actually, speaking of which, I think I would really like to touch base with Ndivo. Ndivo is a fellow live streamer, is a fellow host of his own. Oh, awesome. So he's a fellow live streamer, he's a fellow host. And I think it would be very interesting just to get some ideas from him, just to, you know, some experience. I know that he's been doing quite a lot of streaming, some events that they've done specifically, some shows as well that he's run with.
Mm-hmm.
So Ndivo, if it's cool, man, let me know. We can just pop your number there in the inbox, and I'll give you a shout. And yeah, man, just to share your ideas, your thoughts, your experience. I think other guys that are really interested in live streaming may learn quite one or two things from you. So yeah, please do let us know. That would be really, it'll be a really good thing to have with you. So yeah, guys, like I said, I'm gonna let the music play just a little bit. But just to recap, this is from last Friday night. We had a Friday night dance night as usual. Every Friday night that happens, and yeah, man, we try to dish out some of the best selections that we come across.
Sure.
Not just in the previous, not just in the same week, but obviously in our collection as well.
Yeah.
So this one was curated by yours truly, and yeah, I will make this mix available, and then yeah, hopefully you guys can check it out on this as well as our Mixcloud podcast pages. So yeah, I'm gonna be giving Ndivo a call, and then just to catch up with him. In the meantime, yeah, man, the rest of the guys that are joining, of course, welcome again.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, as usual, I'm with my co-host here, Mr. Solo.
The one and only, man. You already know this.
Yeah. Hi everyone. We have a caller on the line, as I mentioned earlier, a fellow live streamer, fellow show host, fellow this gentleman is quite busy. Yeah, we've got Divo Maginya online here. Divo, how's it?
Chef, how's it?
Awesome, man. Awesome. Yeah, man. How are things going there by you?
Things are going well. I think I've been busy, you know.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, man, just to give you the floor and opportunity, perhaps you want to introduce yourself first before we can dive in into just picking your brain a little bit.
Oh, okay, cool. My name is Divo Maginya. I'm from Venda, and now I'm in Johannesburg because of school and work. Because I'm studying industrial engineering at the university during my final year. Yeah, then I have this baby called Panda Studios that I'm running, a company called Panda Studios, which focuses on live streaming, graphic designing, and professional photography.
Yes.
Sure.
Yeah. Awesome. That sounds great, man. And wow. You sound like a very busy guy. You've got a lot in your hands.
I got a lot going on here.
Damn. Wow. Yeah, man. Can you tell us a little bit about your work with your because I mentioned something about live streaming and you know, the shows that you've been doing. You know, just to give people an idea. I mean, yeah, actually, quite frankly, this is this is me trying to say, sell yourself.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so thanks for the opportunity. So Panda Studios started a while back in 2015. You know, we are 5 years old now.
Wow.
We started as a photography company. Then as time goes by, we introduced other services, and live streaming was one of the services that we recently introduced. We introduced it last year, around September, August 10.
Yeah.
So we basically saw that the world is moving to a very digital, it's going to be a very digital world today. So, because people are creating content, but they're not looking into the content that can be played into, you know, on the go, on smart devices, on smartphones.
Mm-hmm.
Because the TV stations, the big production companies are going to lose business soon, because nowadays people want to have their shows on the go. They want to watch live streaming. Shows that are on the run. So that is basically the reason why we shifted into video live streaming.
Yeah.
And we invested in the same equipment that you're using, the Sling Studio, which is a very powerful equipment, because we get to do whatever that the big production company can do in the OB track, just with with an iPad and then the video mixer with the Sling Studio, and two, three cameras, or an iPhone for that matter. So and I think Corona to us was a blessing in disguise. Like, you know,
not in a bad way.
Okay, listen, gentlemen, he said it. I didn't.
Like, okay, I mean, for our business, which does live streaming. So you know, it get to show people that, you know, live streaming is actually a thing. You know, we are getting into that digital platform where things are going to be done remotely. Like, fourth industrial revolution is manifesting right now. So we are starting to see things coming to action, you know, by live streaming, by remote. I saw this other post on Facebook when they were doing a visual wedding on Zoom to show that now even events are going to be done online. Like, you know, things, the world is going to change. It's going to be a different place altogether.
Yeah. I mean, I totally agree. I think the changes that we are seeing now are quite significant, and
And not temporary, even, man.
Yeah, I mean, so, you know, I feel like some of the changes we may not basically see that they're happening. I have this thing that I said the last time when I was talking to Kaifas here that, you know, it's funny that we basically are going to eventually channel ourselves. We won't need someone to tell us that, hey, you need to social distance. Yes, you know, you need to watch yourself. You need to, you know, be hygienic. You need to, eventually, this practice that we're doing, that's gonna be our lifestyle, and it's gonna be funny. A couple of maybe decades from now, people are gonna be asking, why are people washing their hands all the time?
You know, yeah, all the time.
And then it's gonna be actually, and obviously there's gonna be a lot of conspiracy theories and stuff like that. You know,
sure,
yeah.
But basically, the way that things are changing and the live streaming now becoming a normal thing. I mean, it's like all these things, they started off as if, you know, oh yeah, no, I can actually do a live stream. People can listen to me talk and, you know, but the opportunities that are actually coming with that, it's crazy. And when you now mention that it's a blessing in disguise, yes, I think I agree because, well, I agree in terms of the people that sort of, obviously no one could have foreseen this coming, but the fact that some people, it's like they prepared themselves, you know. When you had this equipment, when you started live streaming, obviously you didn't know, but right now it's actually amazing that, wow, I can actually do all my work just sitting here, and I don't need to like take this videotape to someone and, you know, try to ask them to publish it for me. It's quite interesting.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Wow. Can you maybe tell us about some of your projects that you've been doing? I know that you did some. You hosted the Vendors Got Talent, right? If I remember very well. And you did other stuff as well that I saw you sharing online. You wanna maybe just share some of that with us?
Yes. So as we discussed that, we saw that live streaming is becoming a thing. Mm-hmm. We actually also, you know, saw that we don't have platform to showcase our talent, and more especially in vendor. So for us, when we were growing up, for us to get opportunity to be on TV, to be television stars, we had to come to Johannesburg. So Johannesburg is where all things are made possible.
Sleep outside SABC studios, hoping that someone is going to pick you. But then as you just sleep in there the whole night, they pick Capella and then you're like, oh, wow.
Yeah.
I've got nothing against Capella, by the way. So, yeah. Yeah, please go ahead. Sorry about that.
So for us, we want to bring that platform into our rural area. So we want to have a such platform as like, you know, Go Studio 9, all these big productions that are around here, to have them in our rural areas. And also to be able to tell our own stories and market our own talent, because we have the talent out there. Like, there is actually a lot of talent out there. But we don't have the platform to propel that talent. We can't sell our own craft. Hence, we initiated the project Vendors Got Talent, where we were focusing on giving people platform to showcase their talent.
Yes.
And I think the project went well because we initiated an online competition where we were having more than 10,000 rands worth of prizes that we gave away to four winners.
Great.
So,
wow. Wow. Hey, yeah. My man, some applause for you. I mean, wow.
Definitely.
Wow. I think everybody agrees here. That is some amazing and impressive stuff. But I'm gonna give you a chance to finish. So
go for it.
So we introduced that competition. It went well. By we introduced it on the 20th 6th of March when we are getting into the lockdown. Mm. And by the 16th of April, we had more than 10,000 followers.
Wow.
So it really shows that the growth of the initiative was too much.
Like, wow.
People were interested. People were pinned down to that. They wanted to see what's going to happen. And we are just waiting for this lockdown to end and for us to be safe, to contact coronavirus and all these things, so that we can have road shows. We can be able to go to places and be able to search the talent and live stream it on our platform to show that, you know, there's actually a talent in rural areas. And this idea is sustainable because we can not initiate it only at Venda, but we can expand to other provinces.
Indeed. That's something actually that I was about to ask you in terms of expanding, if you see yourself actually going that route. And eventually we're going to have South Africa's Got Talent, another one by you.
Another one, yes.
Guys, everybody that's listening, you heard it here.
DJ's first, man.
Listen, Divo, guys, please remember this name. yes, please go ahead, Divo.
Yes, yeah, so that is where we are heading right now. And other than doing stuff for giving back to the community, we also, you know, we are also running a business where we live stream our clients, the likes of ENC, the likes of these other churches. We have a lot of clients that we work with that we do their live streaming, and that is what we basically do.
Wow, that is really great, man. Very impressive. Awesome. Wow.
Dude is solid. He's solid.
Yeah, no. I'm really inspired by the work that you're doing, and I mean, wow, the initiatives that you've taken. I mean, I've seen your posts of the stuff that you're doing. I mean, wow, it's really impressive work. I mean, just in case someone hasn't said that to you.
thank you.
from a fellow content creator to another, you are doing great work, you know. And
thank you very much.
And with the initiatives that you're pushing, and I mean, wow. And if there's any way that there can be an opportunity, or just any way that we can actually help out, or we can contribute, or we can actually do some work with you. I mean, I'm looking forward to that, you know.
Yes, I'm also looking forward to that. Yes. Collaboration is always the key. Yeah,
exactly. I mean, there's a whole lot of opportunities out there. And I mean, to the fellow listeners here and everyone that's actually really interested in getting into that kind of platform, the information is there. The people are there. I mean, sometimes some people just don't have access, or they just don't know where to start, you know. So for people that are really interested into going into this kind of environment, what kind of experience, or what experiences can you actually share with them, like the things that they should look at? I know I'm putting you on the spot here. But I'm sure there's some lessons that, you know, some groundwork, you know, some mentality sort of, you know, or behavioral thing that, you know, one must actually be in, or basically I'm not sure if I'm explaining this very well. Okay. Anything that you think can actually help out the rest of the guys that are interested or that are actually doing it, you know, we'll gladly appreciate.
Okay, you mean about live streaming?
Yes, so live streaming, the work that you're doing, you know.
Just basically around the entire service that you're providing, because I see that most of it, it's very much digital. So, you know, MP just wanted to find out, you know, what are some of the traits maybe that one has to possess to basically sort of start.
Okay, cool. Yeah, so I would start with the work that I do, basically, because it's content creation. So we have this, when you are a content creator, you can create the best content ever and upload it on social platforms or on YouTube, because YouTube is basically the one that pays you when you have views and when you're growing your channel and all those. But people don't understand the copyright issues. So they go share your stuff, they go download it and re-upload it on their platform or on their YouTube channel. They don't understand that they're actually taking you down. They think maybe they're supporting, but Bona, they want to grow their channel with your content, it becomes a problem because you're not getting the traffic that you should be getting onto the content that you create.
Yeah, so exactly.
It becomes a problem. So we don't have that platform of our own that we can say, you know, we create content and upload it in African Tube. I don't know, if there's something like that where, you know, we have our own advertisers, we have we are generating our own revenue there. We upload it into this mainstream media, Google, YouTube, Facebook, and all those things.
Yeah, well, that's amazing. I mean, what you're talking about is something that we're talking about, I think, three or 4 weeks ago. That, you know, it would have been a best thing for us not to rely on creating content and shipping it all the way to the US and actually,
just so that we can come back.
Yeah, and
getting it set. Thing of the gold being taken here, then go press the outside and then
exactly.
Like the jewelry.
It's the same thing with content now, which, I mean, it's ridiculous. We shouldn't be shouldn't be doing that. We should have our own tubes, if you want to call it that, for lack of a better word, you know. We should have our own. We should be able to create our own content and not having to rely on, for example, international bandwidth or access. I mean, that's also one of the reasons why the internet is quite expensive, in quotes. You know, that also contributes to that. The fact that we have to get download data from overseas, whatever, the same data that we created ourselves, or the same content that we created, you know.
That's how it is. So
it's wrong.
We must have our own platform. So that is also what we are looking into developing. Also having our own app that we can stream our own content to, so that people can download and have it. And we can stream directly to that so that we can, have our own advertisers in that platform. Those are the some of the challenges that you face when you're a content creator, especially in countries like South Africa as well. So another thing, when we are doing this live streaming, it's nice when you're doing it in Joburg, you have the fastest internet speed, we're using our 5G network here.
Oh yes, yeah.
So yeah, it's easy to do it here. When you go to our rural area, it becomes a problem because, they don't have fast upload speed, network there's no network, proper network there. We have problems. Those are problems that we experience while doing the actual work, while live streaming. Because also in some parts of Johannesburg, 5G coverage is not there. So you actually have to rely on your small router, which is challenging to live stream with that. Because, when you are doing live streaming, you have to understand this thing of internet speed, upload speed, the bandwidth, compression, and all those things.
They become very crucial.
They become very crucial. Also, for people who are looking into doing the live stream, they should actually do the research on products that they can use that can be also, when you want to start a business, you must also check, your packet or wherever you put the location of your business. So if you're going to be mobile, you must get something which is reliable and supplying you with supplying you with the internet. So those are some of the challenges that we experience.
All right.
No. Yeah. So I think you actually started answering some of the questions that I had lined up for you.
Awesome.
So yeah, you're cutting too much on
time. Yeah, you sound like you're prepared for this.
Yeah.
I think there has been
some briefing before here. It sounds very much like that.
Yeah. I think. Well, it wasn't me, but I think you got briefed a little bit.
But yeah, yeah. So I think maybe, you know, rural, it's something that I understand quite well, because I'm actually from the same background as you. And yeah, obviously with power, I think maybe you know, load shedding is not that much of a problem for you for now.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, I didn't hear the question.
No, I was just trying to find out in terms of some of the challenges that you are facing coming from, you know, rural in terms of the live stream. So obviously network, it was one of the issue. And then the second issue that I wanted to find out how you deal with was, energy power. Do you also have issues like that where sometimes, you know, you are busy and then there's like, lights are out.
We had the issue when Eskom was doing the things, you know, the load shading. So when we are doing our live streams, mostly we do them where there's power supply. Like we don't do them over our batteries and in remote locations. But you know, we do them indoors. Yeah.
Mm. Oh, okay. But still, sorry to interrupt you, you depend on solemnly, like only on the grid power, like you don't have your own backup or anything like that.
At the moment, we don't have, but we're looking forward to invest in that. If you can get a generator or battery power source which is reliable, we are looking for it. Yes.
Oh, no, that's impressive, man.
Yeah, no, definitely. Yeah. I think. The other thing is that you also touched on in terms of mobility and all of that. I think that's basically the way to go nowadays. Anyone out there that's, I think with most work, one of the biggest things is mobility. You know, if we're investing in hardware resources right now, I think mobility. I mean, in this day and age, I think mobility is key. We should be able to move around with that item. Otherwise, the challenges become even more.
So if I can just mention one of the other reasons why we started live streaming was the concept of delivery speed. You know, nowadays content is easy to expire. Like, you know, when you have a burning news, or you know, if you don't live stream that, or if you don't showcase that at that moment, a few hours down the line, it's already out of the trending news. Like,
it could be out of date.
outdated. Yeah, something like that. So we wanted to deliver something quickly at that instant.
Definitely. I mean. It's also becoming a bit challenging. Obviously, the same thing you said when it comes to people that create content content that needs to be edited and then uploaded later. If people do live streams, I mean, for example, even the news, you know, the news now, most people don't actually wait for 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock to get the news. People watch the news live. When it's live, happening, someone is out there coding it, and people are actually able to see at that time, you know. And then by the time it trends on Twitter, it's actually late. it's the after effects, you know.
Yeah,
it's the after effects. The story has expired. I think sometimes we just like clinging on things and not letting go.
Yeah, that's true.
That's besides the point, but so yeah, man. I mean, I totally agree. I think live streaming compared to offline recording I mean, that also comes with editing, it comes with effects. And I think most of the time, actually, live streaming is far much better compared to offline content, because sometimes offline content, especially if you find that you're a perfectionist of some sorts, you end up not uploading your content.
You just can't deliver.
You can't deliver because you want it to be so perfect.
Yeah.
But with live streaming, it's actually out there already. So you have to make sure that your groundwork is basically done, and you have to make sure that you do all the due diligence, you know. You can't afford to make mistakes or mess up certain things, because you can't correct that. But with offline it's an advantage that you can later edit certain parts, delete whatever, but at the same time it's more work.
It's done.
And then you end up saying that I'm gonna edit this in post. So
yes,
you end up not perfecting your craft at the get go. But saying that I can do it later in post, and it's more work. But exactly. with live streaming, you must make sure that your colors, your light, is fine, everything. When you live stream, you are done. Like, you deliver the service at the client. That he says, when you go, you are going to another client. You don't have to say, okay, we have to go and edit and do what and do what. So, live streaming is actually, you know, good for business.
No, awesome, man. Okay, so just to share some humor, actually, I was going to ask you to, but I was going to ask you a question first. So, tell us about, obviously the live streaming, there's some challenges or some failure moments which are actually sort of funny, you know, like you're live streaming and then you don't realize that the camera is off. You only see it later after about 10 minutes that my camera was off all along. So like any sort of humorous story maybe that you want to share with us?
I don't have a lot in that, because when I'm sitting in front of the camera, I guess sometimes I live stream myself.
Yeah.
So that is where I make a lot of mistakes. Like you find that I keep my camera microphones on the actual mixer.
Yeah.
So you find that there's echo and everything, and I'm busy shouting and going on, not knowing that people are actually laughing. Right. Can you reduce the volume? Like there's echo, there's what? And when you realize it's late, like I'm 10 minutes into the live stream.
There's I mean, it's those things that offline recording has an advantage on. But I mean, although those experiences are really traumatic, but I think when you think about it later, it's quite funny, something you can actually laugh about and share that experience with someone. Yeah. That, hey, be careful when you do a live stream, make sure that you test your stuff. If you've got batteries, make sure they're charged.
Everything.
You know,
yeah,
if you have, like, the way you position your cameras, watch. Don't just put it there and switch it on. Check it.
Yeah.
Make sure that it sees what you want it to see.
Because
we don't want to see underwear on the wall.
You know, I actually do this live stream while sitting behind the table.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
People can see. So if you make a mistake and stand, if you're just wearing underwear,
it's done.
And more especially for live content, you know, there's no mistake there. If you make a mistake, you go viral. You're gonna trend. You're gonna see yourself on.
Exactly. I'm sure. There's probably one or two people that's watching right now. Like, I'm waiting
for this guy to make a big mistake.
Yeah.
I mean, it happens. It happens to the best of us. Mistakes happen, and I think it's something that people should not take as like a failure. It's something to learn from. You know, the other day, I spilled a drink, and not just once. It happened maybe twice already. Those things, they do happen. And at first, I used to panic a lot. Mm-hmm. You know. I realized that something fell. I used to panic a lot and, hey, I need to correct. Oh my God. Oh, But then eventually I get to learn that, you know what? No.
It's okay.
If I panic, I'm actually making things worse.
Yes.
People that are watching, I mean, also we need to understand that that's also another person that's there. The mistakes that they can make, I mean, I also can make those kind of mistakes. And when you don't see a person on a live stream making such mistakes, then obviously that person is trying their best. You know, that person is trying their best to make sure that they don't mess up.
Yep.
You know, but if you basically put your mind on that to try and not make mistakes, you end up not focusing on the real work, which is to deliver the content, you know?
Yeah. That's true.
Awesome. Divo, I don't know if there's anything that maybe you want to ask us or anyone in the panel here that would like to ask you a question. I'm going to give that opportunity right now to those people. While while we wait to see if anyone has got a question for you, let's check with you if you have a question for us, perhaps.
Hopefully not.
I'm kidding. Go ahead.
I'm the guest here, so I'll allow that platform to be, you know, to be mine for today, and then I will also invite you guys to my platform when I last stream some other time, so that we can share the market and you can share followers as well. So
awesome.
Okay, maybe just before he asks us a question, I don't know if he's still gonna go that route or he's giving up on the idea, but I think it's still open that they can do that. For me, you know, I'm very much interested, man, in what you're doing. It sounds very awesome for me.
Yes.
You know? I was just trying to, you know, to check with you as something that I think might have been a challenge to really bring to, you know, to the people. You know, people are very not easily to take up a new habit. So in terms of the you know, content that you're creating, let's say in some rural vendor or so, you know, the consumption of that content, do you still see most of it being consumed by, you know, rural areas guys, or is it mostly, you know, people like us in Cape Town, in the metros?
So in vendor, I think the market share for live content consumption is growing.
Man, I like Vendor, really, man.
Yeah, Vendor is a great place.
I like Vendor. because I feel that, you know, it's not easy to convince people to have a new habit.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah. No. So go ahead. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's not easy to convince people to fall in love with the new habit, or to follow you on social media, or to understand that nowadays social media is the way to go. Because you can see, like, we used to have pastors in 2010, 2009 saying that Facebook is for devil, like, you know. But now in 2020, same pastors are saying that, you know, follow me on my page. I will be sharing word of God.
I will pray for you.
Yeah, no, that's wonderful, man. That's wonderful.
You see what happens now. So we are moving to that digital space where even old people are starting to see that. Hey, actually, can you download? You know, my mom surprised me one day saying, "Hey, can you please download WhatsApp for me? When are you gonna come back home with your router so that you can connect to internet?"
Great stuff, man. That, you know, that's a wow, man.
we are having change. Like, people are starting to understand this social media and the digital age. Yes. So I think also it's on us to educate them, to tell them, you know, how it works. Because sometimes you might blame them that, you know, people are afraid of change, but you're not telling them how that change is brought about, and
they don't even know what that change is.
Fantastic, totally, man. fantastic.
awesome. Wow. I'm really, yes, you want to say something?
No, I was thinking.
Oh, okay. No, Divo, we're really impressed here about your work, and yeah, man, and the conversation, yeah, there's some enlightenment that we got from you. We really appreciate it. And yeah, man, anything from you, Kaifas, that maybe you wanna...
I just want to, you know, send out, you know, a word of encouragement, if he hasn't got one, to say I think he's doing a superb job.
He
must continue doing that. I think he just won another follower from my side.
No, definitely.
Somebody that is there to stay.
Yes. Oh, actually, sorry, not to cut you off.
Sure.
I was going to say this, actually, I thought about it a couple of times, and now I'm realizing, hey, I shouldn't forget. Can you just maybe share your details in the comments, your pages, where people can actually check out your content and stuff like that?
Okay,
can you do that now, or you can do it after, whenever you're comfortable.
Okay, I'll do it after, I'll type it after, and yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
All right. Cool. Thanks very much.
So, Ndivo. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, we appreciate it, man. Keep doing the good work that you're doing, and yeah, we wish you all the best in your next coming projects and the current that you're doing. And yeah, we wish to connect with you soon and see how we can actually help each other grow. And yeah, man, all the best.
Okay, cool. Thanks for the platform.
No, enjoy it, man.
It's a pleasure, man.
Yeah.
Thanks, Divo. What a guy.
Yeah, no, wow. It just goes to show, man, in terms of the way that the guy is explaining everything, that he did put too much time into really researching and doing his homework.
No, definitely. That's couldn't fantastic. Agree more.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, man, some really impressive takes from him over there. We hope that everyone that was listening actually got something out of that wisdom.
Yeah.
And yeah, we, yeah, he's going to add his details over there for everyone. Yeah, just gonna take a break to the music a little bit, and yeah
drop some bazookas, man.
once again, thank you, Divo, for that great conversation. We hope that everyone had something to take out of that. We definitely did. Divo has shared his details in the comments, as well as his website, where you can get more information about his services. So yes, please do check him out, subscribe to his pages, and yeah, man, some interesting projects that that guy is doing. So some of you maybe might actually benefit from that, or perhaps some opportunities. And yeah, just to go back a little bit, there was some questions in the comments earlier.
Francis.
Yes. yeah, we're actually about, we wanted to answer him as best as we could on that. Okay, so Francis
Jaden.
Yeah, Francis Jaden Maulidi. I don't know if I'm actually saying that right, but yeah, Francis is asking about copyrights. So just to actually read what he asked there. As a DJ and I want to do live streams, how do I go about getting the license to play the music? Okay, trying to upload a live mix without having it to get muted. Struggle of our that's basically our struggle, our daily struggle. Yeah, no, I mean, the same mix that we did on Friday, we had some interesting takedowns. One of the videos, I mean, we ended up having to do three video streams, so one of them is probably like 30% muted. So Francis, so in terms of copyrights, there's some bodies. I'm not sure which country you actually in, but basically, okay, Francis is actually in Cape Town. All right, so from some study or little research that I did some time back, there was some bodies that I bodies, not you know, not corpses or anything like that. So some associations that I came across, I think one of them was called Samro, something like that. What was the other one? I forgot the name, but yeah, it's some. I think one of them is a non-profit organization of some sort, and yeah, I came across two of them, and what they were doing is they mentioned quite a lot in terms of the people that basically about copyright, how it works, and how it's managed, and but their focus was mainly on royalties. So from what I understood from that reading is that you can actually get some kind of a license from them, I believe. You have to register with them. And from what I saw, so let me give you a scenario. So what I saw is that you can register with them, get the license, and then the music that you're going to play, you have to basically go back and show them in a way, and then they will basically pay the royalties for those people. So they give you a license to play of some sort. So from there, now comes the issue of let's say you're playing it on Facebook or you're playing it on YouTube. The other day I read something, I'm not sure how valid that is, that you can actually submit that license to YouTube and or Facebook to show that the music that you are playing, you are licensed to play it, and you actually do submit the playlist thereafter so that royalties can be paid. So I read something like that. I'm not sure exactly the specific process when it comes to that, but that's basically the understanding that I picked up. So those bodies, you basically have to register, and I think there's a certain fee that you have to pay. I'm not sure if it's monthly or yearly, but basically you have to pay a subscription with them. So obviously that process, you know, might just be a little trickier than how I explained it, but I believe that it's possible that you can have a page where you play copyrighted content, but it's not being taken down. So you have to be allowed, basically.
Yeah.
You have to be allowed to play that content. It's possible. And yes, Francis, just to add, besides Facebook, YouTube, I mean, when you speak of DJ mixes specifically, I mean, I don't know if you've checked out Hear This and Mixcloud. Mixcloud have got, they've got a way to actually let people upload copyrighted what is that? For the first time someone has said right on the first go. Oh.
I think I missed it.
Okay, Francis, was that a test? Were you testing me, Francis?
No, maybe he's confirming his knowledge or information.
Yeah. So I'm guessing that you also have a certain, you also have your understanding of how the process works, and I hope that, you and I hopefully understand it the same way. But yeah, like I mentioned, Mixcloud actually allows people to, or allows, yeah, you and I to basically just upload our stuff. They also have some subscription as well. And with that subscription, basically, the music that you play or that you upload, part of that money goes to for royalties, basically. So most of the money goes to the artists that basically whose music you played. And they've actually opened up some opportunities as well, whereby you can give a call if you don't mind.
You drop his number.
Yeah, for sure. I'll get that detail, and then I'll give you a shout.
Yeah,
perhaps we can actually take it a little bit further. All right, I'll give you a shout in a moment.
Tomorrow's my promise.
Yeah, everyone, we have a caller on the line. Francis?
Yes, sir.
Hey, man, how's it going?
I'm good, thanks. And how are you?
We're good here, man. We're good here. Thank you for asking.
Thanks.
Yeah, so you asked some really interesting questions there.
Yes, sir.
I was basically trying my level best to answer you.
when I actually said for the first time someone said that, I was actually talking about my son and not what you actually explained.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, I understood what you said about Samuel. Somebody actually told me about it, but then like he didn't make it clear enough for me to understand like how they work and something like that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. There's a friend of mine who stays about 5 hours away. He's also like doing live streaming. Mm-hmm. But then his problem is whenever he's playing something, because he's normally doing amapiano on his live mix.
Yes.
Mm. So he played a few of Gamma Canal songs, and then after that his mix was muted, or sometimes he was just like taken down.
Yes.
So that's what discouraged me from like starting to do the live mixes anyway.
Yes.
So that's why I had to ask you, like, is there any way of like going about it and doing it the right way?
Oh, I see. So So I mean, to be from my understanding of how this whole copyright thing, for example, on Facebook, how it works.
Yeah.
Or YouTube or wherever. So there isn't one straight rule that applies to all, for example. So there's opportunities that are actually there at the same time, but also the people that own the content or the copyrighted content.
Yeah.
Most of the time, or the way that I understand it, is that they are the ones who tell Facebook and YouTube what to do when their content is matched.
Okay, that makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah, that's why you can play some content which is copyrighted but still not get into trouble. You know?
Okay.
And then there's some content you play, then you get into trouble. So the content that you own, you decide if Facebook should allow someone to play or they shouldn't allow. So basically they are doing what people told them.
Okay, that makes sense. But I've got a few more other questions. Maybe I'm going to ask about one or two of them.
Yeah.
The other question is like regards to like internet speed, because now here that's what I have a problem with. Like how much do you think I should have? Like how fast should it be?
Oh, you mean when you do a live stream of
video? When I'm doing a live stream, like
Well, at the moment we are. I'm going to give an example about us. So at the moment, we basically, our content goes around 5 megabits to 7 megabits, depending on, you know, the size of the video or the resolution of the video. So we are streaming, we are uploading 1920 by 1080p content, but the video is basically just sitting there around 5 megabits per second.
Max, yeah.
Yeah, so
so I guess maybe 10 megabits would be fine for like a decent.
Yeah, it should be enough. It should be decent, enough. Yeah.
Yeah.
The only thing, like the only thing obviously is, remember upload and download.
Yeah.
So you'll be uploading the content. We are uploading it, but at the same time we are downloading it as well. So
that makes sense.
Yeah, because we are also viewing the video that you guys are viewing, you know. But it's the other is one direction, the other is the other direction. The only challenge is if you have other people using the same internet as you, or the same, if it's a fiber or
basically the same
network. Yes. And then they use the same internet line, then you might have some challenges there. It will all depend on the availability of the bandwidth. So, yeah, if you're using it alone, I think even a 5 megabits per second line should actually do the job.
Okay, but
obviously, nah. it will most probably have to only be that.
Yeah, like the main reason why like I've been encouraged to like do my own live mix is because like,
yeah,
locked down and I haven't been playing in a while, so okay, you know, just sitting at home is not really working for me. So I'm just trying to give back, and when people are actually sending me messages like, "Ah, oh, come on, dude, everyone is making live mixes and you're just like chilling at home and you know just doing anything."
Yeah.
So I had to do a setup in the house. Like I don't have the like high-end equipment. The only high-end equipment that I have is like the mixer, which I just bought because I was about to upgrade. So I've got the Pioneer DJM 450 and then the CD100 Samsung CD.
Yeah.
But it's working so far because I tried like recording like a mix into the PC.
Okay.
So it's working just fine.
Awesome.
But then I was just stuck on the part of like uploading it to the part of the internet and then the part of the right.
Yeah. All right. No, that's great to hear, man. And yeah, we hope that it works out, and you're able to actually deliver your content to your clients. But yeah, again, also I think just to be on the safe side, maybe a 10 megabits per second internet line should be. You should consider that. Yeah, just leave enough room for an opportunity, just in case, you know.
Yeah.
And
thanks for the content. Last night was actually the first time I was watching a mix on your channel, because I remember liking the page.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how many months ago, but then like I never paid attention to what happens in the page. Oh. And then yesterday I just came across it and I kind of loved it.
Oh, not wow! Thanks a lot,
awesome,
man. Thanks. We are happy that you actually came back.
I asked that I should get a notification whenever you guys do a live
video. Awesome. Well, That's great, man. We appreciate that. And yeah, sure, we hope that we keep you happy with the content that we create here. And yeah.
Yeah.
And yeah, all the best to you.
Sure thing.
Right. Francis,
yes,
was it two questions or just one question? I think you said two.
I think that's it for now. I'm not sure if I still remember that one. You know, whenever you want to ask something, you always have a lot. And then when the time comes, you always...
Oh,
okay. No, I just needed to make sure that we don't cut you before... You get to the second question, because you know, if I heard you correctly, you said I got two questions. But it's okay.
I actually just forgot the other one.
No, it's fine. When you do remember,
that's fine.
You know where to actually put it. So yeah, and then we'll try our best to answer you.
Okay. Yeah.
Give it up for awesome, Francis, man.
Yeah, man. Thanks a lot. We hope that you're gonna continue watching, and yeah.
I'm definitely gonna continue watching.
Awesome, thanks, man. Awesome.
Good stuff. Cheers. Man. Sure.
Good.
That was Francis. Thanks a lot, Francis, for that chat. And yes, again, we wish you the best in what you're going to be, the journey that you're going to be taking now. It's going to be a very interesting one, with full of some satisfying moments and challenges. But yeah, man, all the best. We have a comment there from Tikedi. Oh yeah, no, definitely, Tikedi. So Tikedi is actually saying, to those who may have not seen his comment, he's actually saying that doing a live stream event is getting easier, but it requires advanced planning and consistent internet. I agree to that.
Absolutely.
I mean, I think something also to do with what we're talking about with Ndivo earlier, to do with planning and, you know, that the certain things that you obviously want to make sure that, you know, you've addressed before you actually jump in it and start doing your live stream. There's some groundwork, basically. that needs to be done. And sometimes jumping those steps can lead to a distraction, which, you know, we wish for no one. So yeah, and consistent internet, definitely, that is very crucial. Yeah, we're just talking with Francis now to do something to do with the internet, and yeah, we agree. Without internet, basically, I mean, yeah, content is well, you can do your offline recording and later upload, but obviously it's not the same as doing a live stream and getting the content delivered at once. So yeah, and thanks to Geddy for that point. And once again, you're watching Home of DJs Sunday Night Chat Night. We are at the Home of DJs headquarters again. Tonight is about conversation. We've had some interesting conversations with very interesting people earlier. Any of you that had an interest or has an interest in joining our conversations, don't be shy. Mm-hmm. We are not only talking to DJs, by the way. Mr. Mo, if you're listening, I put you on the spot right now, but yeah.
It is what it is.
Yeah, I'm actually looking forward to having a conversation with him, but yeah, that's a discussion for another day perhaps. But yeah, so those of you who are just joining, we having a conversation, we're sharing thoughts, we're sharing ideas, we're learning from each other, and we're trying to, you know, learn, or yeah, man, just picking our minds a little bit, and you know, learning from others, definitely. Let me not take the long journey. I mean, that's the point.
Don't reinvent the wheel, man.
Yeah, man. That's the point. So, and yeah, we obviously enjoy that, and the ideas that people are sharing, definitely.
Absolutely.
Yeah, man. Let's go a little bit back to the music. And yeah, Francis, to answer you, yes, our headquarters are in Cape Town. Yes, sir. Let's go back a little bit to the music, and we'll catch up. We'll catch up.
Drop some hydrogen, man. Well, you push me to my limit, boy. Think it's time for us to part away.
Sometimes I really love you. Can't get you out my mind. This is the journey of house music. This is Home of DJs. This is Home of DJs indeed. So we got a little surprise for everyone that's listening.
Yeah. Should you drop it now or? But yeah, go for it.
No suspense, right?
Yeah, no, tell us the future. Tell us the near future.
Yeah, no, we have a surprise for you guys. So normally what we do is we release mixes on our podcasts basically on Saturdays or Sundays. So every Saturday or Sunday, we basically upload a new mix. Some are our own local residential mixes, and most of the time it's basically guest mixes.
Mm-hmm.
So we get content or mixes rather from various people across, and we basically, yeah, we've got a pool of all of that, and through our own internal process we make selections in terms of the schedule of all those mixes. And yeah, man, that's basically how the whole thing works.
Yep.
Going too much into detail.
Yep. And of course all the DJs and friends of DJs, they can tell their friends that Home of DJs is still open to accept your mixes to be featured on the show. Feel free to drop us your contacts and get the guidelines, obviously offline, so that we can feature your content and your mixes here.
Yeah, guys, it's pretty simple, pretty straightforward. You just yourself or whoever you think would be a good fit to actually produce a mix for Home of DJs, basically just get them to send us an inbox on Facebook, Home of DJs page, and yeah, we'll basically take it from there. We'll send the guidelines through, like Kaifas mentioned, and it's pretty straightforward guidelines, not complicated at all. So
if I can understand them, everybody should. It's just that simple.
maybe I should have led with that.
Like, for real, if I can understand these guidelines, I don't think I need to have any reference of some sort really to grasp what the point is here.
Yeah, no, it's pretty simple. I mean, it should be even more simple for people that create content.
Absolutely.
Because the language speaks to them, so... Yeah, so that's basically how we sort of set up our podcast, the weekly mixes that we release. All those mixes can be found on Mixcloud and Hear This. We've got our channel there. It's called Home of DJs. Wherever you see Home of DJs and you see that logo, yes, that's definitely us. If you suspect that it's not, please do let us know.
And report that page just while at it.
Please let us know first before you report. At the risk of actually reporting our own page. So, you know, just try to eliminate that risk. So the surprise that we actually have for you is that the reason why we didn't upload a mix yesterday or today is because we have an exclusive, which is actually an exclusive.
It is, man.
Because this one doesn't come from a producer or a DJ. This one comes from a fan.
Yeah.
Of Home of DJs. Someone who is inspired by Home of DJs so much and the work that we do and the content that we create here. And basically that person got so, you know, they believe that, you know what, I need to do an appreciation for Home of DJs. And they went and they actually created a mix. A very, 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 very wonderful mix. I promise you.
The guy is like, listen here, I think I got this, man. Let me just showcase my creativity.
Yes.
And
yes.
Wow.
Wow. Very, very impressive mix, guys. And that's the reason why we didn't upload it, because we wanted to inform you guys first about the mix. But tomorrow, the mix will be online. And I'm really encouraging all of you that are listening to check it out. You will love it.
Anyway, well, Eric, maybe just give us some feedback on that.
Yeah, guys, check it out and then please let us know what you think about it, how you feel about it. We'll give the details as well as to who the fan is and, you know, what inspired the whole of, well, I just mentioned that anyway, but we'll actually put it on there. So that you guys can actually see that we are not really a closed community. We try and open the doors for everyone, and yeah, man, we try not to discriminate.
Mm-hmm.
I'm really looking forward to uploading the mix, and I hope that you guys check it out and yeah, man, give the guy a shout out. And I hope that you guys love it. I believe that you love it. So, yeah.
Listen here, you know, I needed to say something, but you know, what's playing in the background, it's hitting me the same way it hit me on Friday. So, let's just cut the talking and drop that bazooka, man. Drop the hydrogen. We will come and finish off on the creativity and to really show that, you know, all creativity matters. Yeah. He's a friend who's not a DJ or whatever.
Yeah.
But for now, man, take me back to Friday, man, please.
Okay, this man is not going to sleep from the way that I see
listen
things
to me,
going
man.
Here.
Listen to me, listen to me. Drop that hydrogen. Drop that.
Let's go.
Drop that explosive. Come on, man. Give we it to the guys, house, man.
House. We are the house.
Yeah.
This is the journey of house music. All more features.
Listen to that, listen to that, listen to that.
I know that she left you standing there all alone. You want that pain. Told your family that she's the one. Bro, I know you've tried to give her the best. Simple things in life were never enough. So she didn't wanna be a wife. I know that you've been hurt. She broke your heart. Said she would treat you right. She told you lies. I know that you're in pain. But you are never alone. I know that you've been hurt. She broke your heart. Said she would treat you right. She told you lies. I know that you're in pain, but you don't ever have to do it alone. Don't you cry. Wipe the tears from your eyes. Wipe them tears.
Don't cry.
It's time you give love a try again.
Here together.
It's time you give love a try again. Don't cry.
from your eyes, baby. Don't you cry. You don't never have to do it alone.
Do it alone.
Yeah.
Another exclusive mix. This is the mix from Friday. Friday night, dance night.
Friday night.
And?
Was fire.
That was a dance night, man. I remember not knowing if I should continue dancing or sitting man, down trying man, to, man, to listen to man, this track. Man. But yeah, it was doing some magic. So yeah, I liked it.
It's taking me back. This song is taking me back. I mean, man. I'm not to sound like a sissy, but damn, this track kind of made me emotional for a second, man.
I just knew that it's gonna be explosives when I just saw the headline say "The Return of the Soul Man." Then I knew, man. I knew that. Listen here. I'm gonna be terminated, and when we go to this hour of the Friday dance night, I already know that everything now is catch fire.
You knew that, damn, we're in trouble. I don't know if anyone is ready.
Yeah, that for me, that was my moment, man. When you hit that track, I really enjoyed it, and I'm glad that I can have to experience it again for the second time, man. And every time it sounds very new.
Awesome.
What was going through your mind, man? Let me pick up on you, man. Okay.
I don't know, man. My mind is...
when you're putting this mix together, what was going through your mind? Just when I saw that line, "The Return of the Soul Man."
Yes.
I knew, man.
That is exactly what was going on in my head. The Return of the Soul Man.
No, I thought you wanted to get to me.
Okay. Let me rephrase.
Okay.
The Return of the Fearless Soul Man.
That's the line. That's the line.
That was the inspiration behind this whole mix.
Sure.
The Fearless Soul Man. That's my drive. That's my
Fearless man.
Yeah, man. That's my drive. And yes, I research quite different genres in house music. And I love, I mean, the different flavors in there, the deep tech, like basically deep house, progressive house, melodic house, afro, you know, here and there I love good music.
I can tell.
Let me just put it that way.
I can
I specifically connect with Soulful House.
Couldn't agree more.
So, I specifically connect with Soulful House, and that's why I most specifically, most of my mixes is mostly Soulful House, you know? But I don't discriminate and just, you know, play Soulful House.
Sure.
I do expand. At times, I would put some bit of Afro here and there, or some D-Tech or some melodic deep house here and there. And
yeah, just maybe sometimes confuse me like you do. You know, with some Arab and
some East European, some East European house music. I mean, that's some other flavor. That's crazy. Those guys are. Dangerous.
Yeah, and that's how my soul swinging to their tunes, like, you know. And I think it's music. It does that, you know.
It's the music, man.
You don't need to really know the language. yeah. on itself, it's the language, and
yeah,
you can see it, man, when it shapes you like water, you know, takes
exactly.
you all directions and brings you back, and
yeah,
that's
and,
awesome.
And that's it for me. That's why I'm saying I listen to the different genres, and I play the different genres, but or subgenres, if you wanna call it that. But I specifically connect with soulful house, you know. And me saying that doesn't mean that I don't like other genres or I don't play. No, because I've seen this sort of discussions or conversations online, you know, people offline.
Sure,
I've seen them, and I've seen how they can actually be taken out of context, or rather, people just being funny, you know. I've seen DJs arguing about what's the best genre, you know. I've seen those things, and for me, it's like, really?
They don't deserve.
It doesn't matter.
An argument.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
It's about what you connect with. It's about what you love. It's about
absolutely.
It's about what you feel. You know, I always say that play the music that you feel, that you love. You know, some people, they get confused and they want to focus on, let's say, playing music that that they think people like, you know, or playing music that is popular. I personally don't agree with that. I feel DJs should play the music that they love, or music that they can actually connect with, because and by saying that, it I don't necessarily mean to say that well, it doesn't matter who's there, who's listening to your music, you must just play what you love. I'm not saying that.
Correct.
There's a whole lot of genres and subgenres out there, and if you feel that progressive house makes you lose your, you know, that's
your screws.
I think that's where you need to focus at. If you feel that Afro house is the way to go, if you feel that whatever genre, that's what you need to, I mean, invest your time and effort in, because that is going to be satisfying to your soul.
So what I correct me if I'm right or wrong. So what I hear you saying is that you play the music to sort of display, you know, your not only your creativity, but what really makes you move.
Yeah, show us who you are.
So I think I got it. It's sort of an expression. I don't know if that
Djala,
word is right.
Show us who you are.
Yeah, yeah. So I think it's a way of expressing.
You remember this phrase, right?
Yeah, yeah.
It's maybe not directly like that, but that's basically that. It's similar.
Yeah, yeah.
Show us who you are. The music that you play should tell us who you are and the story that you're trying to tell people.
Wow.
That's what I believe.
Wow.
You know? Some people are shy to play the music that is, I mean, one of these days I'm don't be surprised that when you hear me opening up with a classical song or opera.
Just to terminate.
Can I get a show of hands for those that agree that I should actually open with an opera song? Because I would definitely do it gladly. I would love to do that. Because that's my stuff. I love classical music. I love opera.
Sure.
You know? And yeah. You wouldn't hurt me once in a while, you know, just throw a little bit of
some good music.
Yeah, there's some orchestral stuff.
Yeah,
there.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
You know, but I'm just saying this, you know, just to show that, you know, sometimes we think that, oh no, I have to play this, people will love this, not knowing that maybe what you actually love yourself is what people.
There are many others that also feel the same.
Yeah, because if you play the stuff that you love, you will enjoy it.
See,
it will be satisfying because it's what you love. your emotions will show, your actions. When I you like play it. The music, your actions will tell how you're feeling about that music and if you actually love what you're doing.
What you're doing.
You know, some people can make people hate playing music because of the dictatorship that that is out there. I know it's a very big word, but
yeah.
Yeah, I mean, guys, those that are listening, I mean, if you disagree with me, please. If you agree also, would love to hear from you what you think about that. But for me, definitely, I believe that people should play the music that they love the same way they do when they're sitting alone.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine. Wouldn't this be like a very interesting thing to actually find out? Find that all of us, when we're sitting in our own private spaces, we actually listen to classical music.
Yeah, but that's one thing that is true. Especially with classic, that first you will think that you don't know it.
Yeah.
But once you know, couple of notes I've been,
yeah,
you know, hit, you start to feel that you can move for that.
Yeah.
It has been illustrated by many maestros. That classic is,
everybody loves classical music.
Everybody loves classic. They just don't know.
You just don't know it yet.
Yeah.
If you don't, if you feel that you don't.
Yeah.
So I mean, take for example, people love rhythm and soul.
For sure, but she's.
Okay, although maybe this is another discussion. Maybe this is another topic, because I was going to say that I was going to say that people love rhythm and soul, or rhythm and blues, however you want to call it.
Yeah.
But sometimes people are just shy to play it. Maybe because they will be judged.
That's okay. Or maybe because, that's so what, that's
or,
so
or maybe because they will look weak.
Yeah.
You know? I don't know, but it's one of those things. Why don't people play soul or blues or rhythm?
See,
you know, in their cars now, you hear boom, 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 boom. Oh, wow.
What's popular?
Yeah, you hear like, hey, wow.
What's socially acceptable?
It's a nice song. Whoa, that's a nice, this is a new album by whatever. But do you love that? Do you love that music though? You know? I think. We need to start listening to the music that we love, not what is popular. You know?
No, I fully agree.
Temba, hey, how's it going, bro? Hope you're well, man. Nice voice. Temba, yeah, that's awkward, man. Nice voice. You too.
Good evening, Temba.
You too, Temba.
Wait a minute, man.
Oh, here's another one. Here's another bazooka, man.
Take it up. Let's.
Yeah, let's just go up a little bit.
Yeah, let's take it out.
We got a few minutes. Wow, time just went so fast.
Probably having a good time.
Yeah, man. I mean, look at the time. It's like almost 2 hours. I mean, wow. That's crazy.
I'm having a good time. That's why.
It's crazy, man. It's crazy. Let's go up a little bit. Here we go.
Let's
This is Home of DJs. I'm your host, Regalo Senior. As usual, sitting with my co-pilot, Mr. Kaifas, aka
Solo, man.
Solo.
Yeah, man. Interesting night we're having.
I'm having a good time.
Yeah. Yes, Brony. Totally. That's a beautiful track. Beautiful track.
So Bruno actually enjoys the same kind of music. So he will love this Friday mix. Is it uploaded already?
No, this one, it's only the video, which is on
the line.
Yeah, which is on Facebook.
Yeah.
So the whole mix that. The whole video, live stream video that we did on Friday is still there.
It's available there.
Yeah, but yes.
I want him to have it in his car.
I'll be uploading the mix, definitely, for sure. The video as well will be uploaded to YouTube. So I'm busy trying to sort that out also. So yeah, we'll get there. So yeah, I see we've got a few minutes left. It's just this point that I wanted to highlight. It's in relation with a conversation that we had with Francis. So yes, sure thing, Brony. We'll send you the link to the previous video, which is on our page. Also the mix will be uploaded to Mixcloud and hear this. So we'll put those links in the comments so that you can check out our previous mixes as well as the video for this one. I will upload that mix, the audio, at a later stage.
Brand new wallet, so, yeah. Edit, subscribe so that you get content first time.
Yeah, the notifications, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, also on YouTube, I mean, if you search for Home of DJs, you will actually find one of the videos that we uploaded there. So yeah, speaking of YouTube and the conversation that I had with, that we had with Francis. Rather. So in terms of this whole copyright thing, now going a little bit deeper. So the people that create the content, which the music rather, the artists or the production companies. So they decide what should happen when their content is matched. So there's instances where they say to Facebook or to YouTube that when my content is matched, you must delete that video. Basically, yeah, the video must be taken down. It won't be available to anyone. And there's another option where basically it's related to fair use, all those. But basically what happens is that Facebook, it meshes the content, but Facebook or YouTube doesn't take it down because the owner of that content
basically decided
that they shouldn't be taken down. And what happens there is, what I actually came to learn as well was that when that happens, yes, Osla Deep.
Yes, that's what I was telling you.
Yes, indeed.
I can't
indeed.
Concentrate
indeed.
No more.
Indeed, indeed. Yeah. Marina.
Yes.
So that's a lovely tune. Lovely tune indeed. So yes, like I was saying, what happens is that when your video plays, you cannot make money out of the ads that get played on your video. The owners of that music will get
portion of
the money that YouTube is gonna obviously pay for the ads and whatever. They will get the money, not you. And I find that to be fair.
Yeah.
I find it to be fair. Fine. I make a mix, I promote your music, I put it out there, put the video online, fine. I promote my channel, but I also promote your music. I don't get paid for the ads that get played on those videos, but the money goes to the artist. So at the same time, I feel like if that's the case, so why do other artists or production companies or record labels basically want stuff to be taken down if they can actually, you know?
Leverage on that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But hey, couple of minutes left. Let's just give this a shot, specifically for Bronny.
Did you just see that question?
Bronny.
Did you just see that question?
Wow, 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 wow.
Even good things come to an end.
Wow, wow.
And normally that can bring some sadness to other people.
How much time do we have left? Oh, man. So sorry. But that was our time. Basically, we went over by 3 minutes now, so
and counting.
Yeah, so that was our time, but thanks a lot, Bronny. We will put those links. Artwork featuring Tumelo, yes, one of the beautiful tunes in this mix as well. Yeah, definitely love that. Love that. That's the song that got me a little bit emotional, but yeah, trying to be strong. So yeah, thanks. Thanks to everybody that watched tonight, everybody that joined us. We really appreciate. Thanks, Bronny. We appreciate also the conversations that we had, Francis, Ndivo, Yemen, and everyone else we interacted with. In the comments as well as via the inbox. We appreciate the conversations, guys, as always. While we prepare for the next Sunday night, please do check us out on Friday. Our previous... Francis, yeah, we'll take that into consideration. We'll take that into consideration. Perhaps we actually should do that. This 2 hours feels very short somehow. But yeah, we always enjoy and we always appreciate the feedback that we get from you guys. And we hope that today's discussion actually extended some knowledge to everyone that was watching and listening. I definitely picked up a couple of things, and yeah, man, very informative as always. And I hope you guys feel this. I mean, you guys feel the same. Kaifas?
No, absolutely. So yeah, for me, just my takeaways. Mm. I realized when Dev was giving some background there that look, there are risks that we cannot really omit, but rather have some sort of a plan just to manage the risk, and things should be fine. So I found that to be very inspiring for the other guys that are also into producing the you know, content or any other thing that they want to do, you know, with their creativity.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so it was a great night. Like I said when we started, you know, I hope the other guys had as much fun as we do. And yeah, I hope that they catch us again on Friday dance night. And we have a conversation again on Sunday.
No, definitely. Yes. And also, as a reminder, please check out our pages, check out our podcasts on Mixcloud. On Hear This, it's Home of DJs on all those platforms. On YouTube as well, we uploaded a video there. We've got some that are scheduled to be published. And yeah, Instagram as well, we do have our page. It's called Home of DJs. So yes, wherever you go, Home of DJs. that's the name. And yeah, guys, do check out our channels and do subscribe. And as promised, tomorrow we'll be uploading a fan mix, a very exclusive mix from a fan, someone who dedicated a mix for us, just to show appreciation to Home of DJs. And we hope that you guys check out the mix, and we hope that you love it. We definitely do love it. And yeah, we will have a conversation about it and just break it down and get the curator online. You guys can pick their brain a little bit, and I hope that he's ready. Or she, or is it a he?
Let's find out on Sunday.
We'll find out. Looking forward to tomorrow, guys. The mix will be online, and yeah, if you haven't subscribed to our Mixcloud and Hear This, please check it out. The mix will be uploaded there. And yeah, man, wishing you a great night,
great day,
great week. I'm
out.
Yeah, man, we're out.